Welcome to Africa's Grandest Gathering, the 12th edition of the Cape Town International Jazz Festival organized by ESP Africa. My name is Ike Partler, and I'm going to be hosting these press conferences throughout the day. And today we start off with a music producer, songwriter, singer, entrepreneur. He's got his own record company. He's got only one album recorded, released in 2009. It's titled Raw Jazz. Please welcome Hanjen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
And good morning.
Just to let you know, when we have the next break, accreditation armbands will be available at the media office, and you can go and collect them once there. So we're getting ready for the Flames to come through.
Hi, I'm Kathy Stagg. I grew up as a schoolgirl listening to you guys. And what I found interesting was that you used to play in whites-only venues some of the time. And I remember schoolgirls that used to be in your van pretending that they were coloureds, because if the cops knew that they weren't coloureds, everybody would be in big trouble. So I want to know, was it a thing that the authorities were seen of as older people, and that for younger people who were keen on music, apartheid actually was something that you just had to get around?
The music inexplicably breaks down things
all
in a way that, you know, it just happens. I think it's a natural occurrence. And I think still today there's people, we all have different values about things. And you know, I can remember him being pulled away from somebody who he was autographing on a body at the City Hall. And the policeman didn't like it. He said, "You can't do that," and pulled away. So I'm just signing my autograph. He's got a good line in a song that says, "The status quo needs a refugee, but the music is free."
I'm a rural girl from rural Transkei. I grew up walking barefoot to school. I was the ideal poster African child, you know, the one with the snot and the ragged clothes and barefoot and smiling, huge smile on camera and running after the car that drives through. We cannot have in Africa and post-colonial Africa a colonial language as the main language of doing business and of instruction. We need to be able to choose one African language that we all feel that there are strong similarities, or that we all feel that we identify with as the national language.